help determine if the fractal structure of a single tree can predict how an entire rainforest works.
Measurements of its trunk, next.
Enquist has traveled to Costa Rica, to Guanacaste province in the northwestern part of the country. The government has set aside more than 300,000 acres in Guanacaste as a conservation area. This rainforest, like others around the world, plays a vital role in regulating the Earth's climate by removing carbon dioxide from the atmosphere.
If you look at the forest, it basically breathes. And if we understand the total amount of carbon dioxide that's coming into these trees within this forest, we can then better understand how this forest then ultimately regulates the total amount of carbon dioxide in our atmosphere.
With carbon dioxide levels around the world rising, how much CO2 can rainforests like this one absorb? And how important is their role in protecting us from further global warming? Enquist and a team of U.S. scientists think that fractal geometry may help answer these questions.
Let's try to get the height of the tree measured here.
They are going to start by doing just about the last thing you'd think a scientist would do here. Cut down a balsa tree. It's dying anyway, and they have the permission of the authorities.
So Christine, as soon as you know the height of that tree, you can actually figure out the approximate angle that we need to take it down on.
Hooking a guideline on a high branch helps ensure the tree will land where they want it to.
Very good, very nice.
Nice.
Jose, perfecto.
Enquist and his colleagues then measure the width and length of the branches to quantify the tree's fractal structure.
8.06.
They also measure how much carbon a single leaf contains, which should allow them to figure out what the whole tree can absorb.
So if we know the amount of carbon dioxide that one leaf is able to take in, then hopefully using the fractal branching rule, we can know how much carbon dioxide the entire tree is taking in.
Their next step is to move from the tree to the whole forest.
All right, this is good.
13.2, 3.3R.
We're going to census this forest. We're going to be measuring the diameter at the base of the trees, ranging all the way from the largest trees down to the smallest trees.
3 meters above the ground.
And in that way, we can then sample the distribution of sizes within the forest.
It's 61.8 centimeters.
Even though the forest may appear random and chaotic, the team believes it actually has a structure. One that, amazingly, is almost identical to the fractal structure of the tree they have just cut down.
The beautiful thing is that the distribution of the sizes of individual trees in the forest.
Oh, it's from the indigenous people.